Hey there, Lisa Pizek here, and in this podcast, I want to talk to you about contribution and starting to think about your business as contribution, starting to think about the way you interact with people day in and day out as contribution. Because I think as humans on this planet, we want to do good, we want to live with purpose, and we want to feel connection with people. We want to feel like we matter. We want to feel like our work matters. We want to feel like we're enough. I think at the end of the day, that's what pops into our brain at night. Like, did I give enough? Did I contribute enough? Am I happy? Those are a lot of the questions that I think as humans, we don't want to admit that we worry about or that we think about. And I'm reading this book right now called The War of Art by Stephen Pressfield. It was given to me by a mentor, and I want to share with you a quick excerpt that like just hit me. Whoa, contribution. Are we living into the person that we know we can be? Because a lot of times it's not about strategies and tools and toolkits and digesting more information about how to be more productive or how to lose weight or how to master that live video. It's not about that. It's the belief of ourselves and are we on the right path that I think keeps us up at night when the answer to that question isn't what we want it to be. And it's called The Artist's Life. And he writes, are you a born writer? Were you put on this earth to be a painter, a scientist, an apostle of peace? In the end, the question can only be answered by action. Do it or don't do it. It may help to think of it this way. If you were meant to cure cancer or write a symphony or crack cold fusion, you don't do it. You not only hurt yourself, even destroy yourself. You hurt your children. You hurt me. You hurt the planet. You shame the angels who watch over you. And you spite the Almighty who created you and only you with your unique gifts for the sole purpose of nudging the human race 1 millimeter farther along in its path back to God. Creative work is not a selfish act or a bid for attention on the part of the actor. It's a gift to the world and every being in it. Don't cheat us of your contribution. Give us what you've got. I read that and it stopped me dead in my tracks. The do it or don't do it. I love that because how many of us are stuck in inaction right now? You think that the product or the program or the service is not perfect, so you won't launch it. The sales video isn't perfect, so you won't launch it. You feel like you aren't smart enough to get out there and do that pitch or go to your boss or ask for whatever it is, whether that's money or vacation or time or whatever it is in your job. You don't want to go and ask that person out on a date because you don't feel confident enough. You don't want to get in a bathing suit and run around with your kids at the beach because you're worried about the way you feel. It's like, do it or don't do it. But know that by not doing it and then not making any changes is cheating the world, is cheating your family, is cheating your potential. I just love that. Do it or don't do it. It's like there's no in between. There's no limbo. You're not stuck in transition. By not doing something, you're taking action, but it's in the wrong direction. So what's one thing you can do to start taking action in the right direction, regardless of the outcome? Because action is still doing something. Action is still moving you forward as opposed to not doing it, which is moving you backward. I also love how he says, you hurt me and you hurt the planet. You shame the angels who watch over you and you spite the Almighty, who created only you with your unique gifts. I was helping a client yesterday task through what made her program different. So she's a coach with me. She is in network marketing, but she's developing her own brand, and recipes is something that her tribe wants from her. Her ideal client wants from her. They want recipes. They want healthy, family-friendly recipes. And I said, okay, that's great. But people can easily go on Pinterest. They can go on YouTube. They can go on good old Google. All recipes, I mean, there is endless amounts of recipes there people can find. There's endless amounts of nutrition coaches, fitness coaches, health coaches, you know, clean eating bloggers. There's lots of that out there. So it was what makes her different. And we came up with that. It's the actual process around what they do as a family in the kitchen that makes her toolkit or her recipes different. So not only are you going to get the recipe, you're going to get a grocery list with it. So that takes the stress away. You're going to get tips of how your children can be involved and in the specific steps of that recipe, what your kids or your spouse or other people can be doing to make it a family approach. You're also going to get, we decided, music pairings, almost like we have food and wine pairings or food and beer pairings, because she loves to make it an experience with her family. So based on the recipe, you can get a music pairing that you can play with it while you're cooking and make it fun. And then lastly, games at the table. Now, if you steal this idea, we will hunt you down and murder you. No, I'm kidding. But don't steal this idea. But this is what we came up for her, that you're also going to get games at the table that you can play as a family once the meal's cooked and you sit down and make the whole experience fun. So it's not just clean eating recipes that the family will love, that you can get on the table in 30 minutes or less. It's what makes that unique to her, the way she implements it in her family and the way she coaches others through it. So I want you to take a look at all of your products and programs in business, and I want you to ask yourself, what makes this unique to me? And are there any tweaks that you can make, any little added touches or an added bonus or something that makes it unique to you? In health or in your family, I want you to think about how can you make the experience unique to you. So how can you, is the music that you listen to when you're working out that can give you that extra push that's unique to you? Is it the space that you exercise in that gives you creative inspiration? Remember, this book is all about being creative that inspired me to make this podcast. In your relationships, is there a fun ritual that you can have? Like every Friday night, my husband and I love to do wine and charcuterie. We make our own because we realize that we pay lots of money when we go out. Although sometimes it's lovely to do that. But we take those experiences that we love when we go out and we become homebodies and we create them at home. So we'll have charcuterie and we'll have oysters and we'll have wine. And our little guy loves pizza. So Friday night is typically pizza for him. And then wine, charcuterie, oysters for hubby and I, and we watch a movie. And it's like we shut off the phones, we shut off the devices, we shut everything off so that we can connect as a family. But that's, instead of going out and spending money, we do it at home. And that's just a ritual that every Friday night, my little guy, our four-year-old, our little guy, he knows that it's pizza and movie night. And he loves that. So is there some sort of ritual that you could make unique to you? I mean, we see a lot of families that do ugly sweater around the holidays, or they all get matching onesies and pajamas. And you can't tell me your heart doesn't skip a beat or you don't smile when you see that posted on social media. That's unique, that you're like, I can stand by that. That's cool. How can I do that in my family? We name our Christmas tree every year, always with a B. So we've had Big Bubba, Big Bertha, Big Bert, Big Betty. Big Boo Boo was what our little guy named it last year. And the reason why it's big is because the first year that we got a Christmas tree, I have terrible spatial awareness. And I was like, that's the tree. That's the winner. When we saw it out, you know, in the wild or out at the tree farm, cut her down. And my husband's like, babe, that is never going to fit like in our living room. It's just way too big. And I'm like, no, that is the tree. Got it, got it home, you know, cut it down, got it home, and we actually had to take out some of the furniture because it literally was like in the middle of our living room and like overtakes like our seating area. We'd take out the coffee table, we had to move some of the couches. And we laughed so hard about that, that that's our thing every year when we go to pick a Christmas tree. We're like, nope, not big enough, not coffee table worthy to have to take out. So what is unique to you? And then we name it Big Bubba, Big Bertha, Big something, Big Boo Boo. What is unique to you that you can bring more fun back into your life, into your family, into your relation, even into your work? Yeah, your relationships, but your work. You think about if you're not a home business owner or a solopreneur or the CEO, you spend a lot of time at work. If you work a 9-to-5, make it fun. How can you make it unique to you? Or if you want to get that promotion or you want to level up at your work, what's a unique gift or talent that you can bring to the table? You can sit at that table and offer that forward because you have unique talents. You have unique gifts. You just haven't been tapping into it and you haven't been using it. And then as I said in business, go back and look at your courses. What makes it unique to you? So I wanted to come on. I wanted to make this quick podcast because that just inspired the hell out of me. That was a kick in the pants when I read that. One page, I don't say one liner, although the do it or don't do it, that's a one liner that stuck with me. So I want you to go assess and do the same. What are you going to do? What are you going to go and do this month, this week, this day? What is unique to you that you can flip it and you can switch and you can have more fun in your personal life, or you can have more impact or influence at your job or in your business? Because as he said in this book, you are cheating yourself, your family, the world. If you're religious, you're cheating God that gave you those gifts. You have to step into your power and you have to believe that you have power and you have those unique gifts. So allow yourself some time to write, to journal, to answer these questions. And I promise you that is going to give you a kick in the pants to go make some changes in your life. If you need some more help, if you need some coaching, head to www.lisapezik.com. Connect with me on there. I'm a body, brand, belief, and business coach, and I'm here to serve you. See you over there.